Hi and welcome. In this video, I am going to show you how to join a computer to a domain. That is, I have total four systems. Of these four systems, this A101 is the Active Directory or domain controller. And remaining three machines are individual computers. So I want to join these three computers to the Active Directory. It means I am going to bring this three computers to a single domain. How do I do that? This is a VirtualBox setup. So how to set up this virtual machine inside the Oracle VM VirtualBox? I have done a separate video. I will leave a link in the description. You can click on that link and watch the video. So let us begin our session. Let me start this machine. This is my domain controller. Let me start this machine. So machine is starting. Enter the password. Here you can see this is the domain name and this is the administrator account. So my domain is sqlforest.com. I am entering my password. So this is my domain controller. So let me start the other machine. Let me minimize this. So I'm going to start this machine A104. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to add this A104 to this Active Directory, which is sqlforest.com domain. So I'm logging in. So here I'm not using the domain account. This is the local PC administrator account. For this A104 machine, this is the administrator account. So when I add this PC to the domain, I can even log in with the domain account to this PC. So first log in with the local administrator account. I'm logged in. So the first thing I am going to do here is to disable the firewall, but in real time you are not going to disable the firewall, you are going to allow the IP addresses. Since this is a demo purpose, I am going to disable the firewall. Windows firewall with advanced security. So not to have any issues to connect to the PC, I am just disabling this firewall settings. Just off. Apply. Now open network and sharing settings. Just go here, right click, open network and sharing center. Otherwise you can also do this from your control panel. I'll show you. Control panel, network and internet. You can see network and sharing center. Here go to change adapter settings, double click on this Ethernet, go to properties. Here go to internet protocol version 4, TCP IPv4 and properties. Here use the following IP address. Give some IP address. Let me give 192.168.10.4 and just click here the subnet mask. It will give the subnet address and here preferred DNS server. Here you need to enter the IP address of your domain controller PC. So go to your domain controller PC. IP config. and see the IPv4 address. It is 192.168.10.1. Take this IP and write in this machine. 192.168.10.1 and click OK. Now close this, close. Now go to this window symbol, right click on it, sorry, click on this and go to control panel and then system and security and then go to system. You will get the system properties, or you can directly go here, close this, right click here, you will get system, click on it and then go to change settings. You can see the computer name, change settings. Here you will get the system properties. If you want to change the computer name, you can change from here. So my computer name is A104 and you can see here it is a member of domain. Tick this checkbox and enter your domain name. So my domain name is sqlforest.com. This is my domain name and okay. So it will ask you to enter the credentials of this domain account. Once you add the once you give the credentials of this domain account, this computer will be going to add in the particular domain. There is some error here. Domain name is correct. Let me check the network settings. Here I have to give host only adapter, or you can even give internal network. Okay, now go and check. Okay, see, it gave you a window to enter the credentials. This username will be your administrator account of the particular domain sqlforest.com and the related password. So username is same, administrator and password, and click OK. Welcome to sqlforest.com domain. So this computer has been successfully added to this domain. Click OK and then you need to restart this machine. You must restart your computer to apply these changes. Click OK, close, restart now, yes, restarting. Sign in. Here you can use this administrator account of the local PC, but since I have added this PC to the domain controller of sqlforest.com, I want to log in with the administrator account of the domain. Go back, click on this other user. You can see here, sign into sqlforest. Give the username of the administrator and the related password. I have entered the username and password sqlforest/administrator and the password and enter. This is how you add a system or a computer to the domain. So what is this use of adding the computer to a particular domain? So I'll show you a real-time example. So this is my domain controller. This is my domain controller. Okay. So here I can check the list of computers which are a part of this domain. Go to server manager. And then tools, active directory, users and computers. Click on these computers and you can see the name of computer A104. these two are I added previously, and this is the computer which I have added just now, right? So I can manage this computer using this domain. So I'll show you a simple example. If I go to users, before that let me show you logout of the system. I'm signing out and so when I click on this other user, I can manage the user credentials from the domain account. I'll show you now. So go to users, right click, new user, give some username abcd. So login name is sqlforest/abcd. So this user can log in to any computer which are part of this sqlforest.com domain. Next, mention the password. And next, so this is the username, abcd is the username. So the user has been added. Now I can log in to this A104 machine using this credentials, abcd credentials. Understood? This is how we manage the users and the computers which are a part of the sqlforest.com domain. Even I can reset the password of this user also using this domain controller. From here I can disable the account, even reset the password and manage the user from this domain account. Okay, I hope you have understood the concept and managing the users using this domain account. If you have any queries in adding the computer to the particular domain, or if you face any issues, please do comment below and I'm happy to answer your queries. Thank you.